Hello everyone and welcome to this Tefra guide. My friend Zonsteel will speak the intro for you. Let's hear what he has to say.
Wolfside is a very great player. He is full with gold. I wanna suck his nipples. Yeah.
Okay, after that charming speech, we dive straight into the Tefra. Okay, first of all, this is the Tefra tree. And here, on top of everything, is the Tefra, of course. At first, we must collect Tefra, of course. And it looks like this. It's a dark black rock, and it's mostly deep down in mines or in the Tefra crater. On our way to the glorious Tefra crater, we encountered some shady scoundrels.
I think actually we can kill them. You know I'm the best PvP'er here.
Yeah, we all know it's on sale.
Stop running, little.
For those who wonder, here is the Tefra crater. It was dark, so you can't see much, but there you can see a lot of Tefra. All the black stones are Tefra. And let's collect a little bit of Tefra and move on. Now we take our Tefra and throw it in the grinder. We use the grinder for that because the grinder is the only operation where you can get out the most galbinum from Tefra. And galbinum is later used for aquamium production, chromite production and something more. You can also use other stuff as catalysts, a link in the description. Okay, now we have acquired all 5 tier 2 materials. And now we will look closer to the red bleak blend extraction. And first of all, you need a furnace. Better you use the blast furnace in Gaul Core, because you will get much more materials out of your red bleak blend. The calculation goes as follows. 1 stack red bleak blend with fuming salt as catalyst. You can also use 1000 rock oil, but the fuming salt is recommended because you get a little bit more sanguinite out of it. Now we have extracted some Aben, or how I call it, a BAM! Because it's like when you smack someone, it's like BAM, you know. Okay, let's move on. Aben can be used for heavy weapons, but it's also good for building and stuff. But because it's a side product like bleak or something. Some silver, of course. Literally too shitty for a weapon material, even for armor, so maybe building. And we get out some calamine for mages, for example, but you can also use it as catalyst for some other operations. Just check the link below. And last but not least, the sanguinite, the most important stuff from Red Bleak Blend. Very important because you use this to make ogmium later in the refining process. One little side note here, you can get your catalysts from the regent vendor if you can't extract them for whatever reasons, or if you want to save some time. But we don't know if Starvault will change what is available at the reagent vendor. So always look for other catalysts too and what they can do. Link in the description, by the way. Okay, let's focus on the magmum extraction. If you extract the magmum, you will get out cyanide, pyrrhopite and malite. Cyanide is very important to make ogmium later. Malita is a finished end product, you can use it to craft some weapons, spears are exceptionally good with it. And pyrrhopite is not very useful. If someone knows something, please in the comments. I mean, I played long enough and I searched my ass off and I didn't find its uses. If you want to extract magmum and you want to get out cyanide to make ogmium later, then you throw it in the grizzly. With coke or with sulfur. Or boar. But if you wanna get out more malite, because maybe you're not interested in ogmium or something, then the calculation goes as follows. I don't have the footage of the kiln operation right now, but you will get out much more malite out of your magmum. Of course, the cyanide is missing, but if you aren't interested in making ogmium or some of that stuff, then do that. Okay, now we will look at the cinnabar extraction. You can get out ichor and sulfur. You can both buy these right now at the reagent vendor, but also be aware of some changes. Maybe someday Starvault will remove the ichor and the sulfur from the reagent vendor, and then it's pretty good that you have the knowledge about how to extract cinnabar. If you extract cinnabar, it's best if you throw it in the furnace if you want to get out ichor. Use a catalyst like boar, you can use many other catalysts, but boar has proven to be the best out of all. For that operation, of course. But if you wanna get out more sulfur than ichor, then you use the fabricula. You will get out much more sulfur this way. You can also use the Notorus or the Greater Notorus to get even more sulfur out of it, but this is simply too much for this video. This is just how is the best way or the most practical way to do things. Okay, let's talk about Galbinum. You will get out Pyrite and Lupium and Pyroxene. Pyrite can be used as a mage for Earthquake, for example. We don't know how Starwolf will implement the magic system, but I think it will be used again. And Lupium, of course, to make Tungsteel. Tungsteel is needed for refining Ogmium, but please check the section in this video. And much Pyroxene is needed for as much Acronite as possible and as much Almine as possible in order to make a lot of Chronite or Ogmium. I don't have footage of the Great Natorus, but it's not necessary, I guess. In order to get as much Pyroxene as possible, I would highly recommend only use the Greater Notorus for that, because every other operation don't even come close to that. Even if you use the Blast Furnace and not the normal furnace, you will just get out about 1000 Pyroxene. So I really recommend to pack your shit up, go to the Greater Notorus, get your group ready, because I think it will be camped 24/7. Okay, now to the Pyroxene extraction. You will get out Electrum and Calamine and Acronite, again very useful for Chronite and Ogmium, as the name already suggests, and Almine for refining Tindramic Messing or Chronite. To extract your Pyroxene, you should use the Blast Furnace. Even witches get extracted here, but right now we only extract Pyroxene. As catalyst you use Calx Powder, and you will get out a lot of Acronite and Almine. If you want to get more Almine, you can use the Greater Notorus, but you won't get much Acronite out of it. I highly recommend to use the Blast Furnace and not any other operation besides the Blast Furnace and the Greater Notorus, because you will end up wasting a lot of materials. And the last extraction for today, we will look at the Electrum. You will get out Gold. That can be pretty useful if you want to make the heaviest armor in the game for no reason, and the Silver for exactly the same reason. I know no one who actually used Gold or Silver in any combat related stuff. And you will get out Cuprum, of course. You can make pretty good spears out of it, and it has some more use cases, but we don't discuss it right now. If you have the option, you can extract your Electrum in the Blast Furnace, but you can also use the regular furnace. The yields are much less, but I think it's not so important, because gold and silver is more a useless product, to say the least. But you can use gold and silver for alchemy multiplier and some other stuff. And Cuprum, of course, for spears or some other stuff. Okay, now to the refining. The refining is always in a 2:1:1 ratio. Don't get completely overwhelmed by all the wall of text, but that are all refining recipes. Now you know where you get the materials from, and now you can use it to make Chronite, Tungsteel, Ogmium, whatever you want. And of course, as always, make sure that your skills are high enough, that you have at least read all the books you need in order to extract something, because otherwise you would waste many materials. And as always, support me on Patreon, follow me on Twitter, Instagram and all that bullshit, like, subscribe, hit the bell, and goodbye!